Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Richard Kuo here, and I'm going to read aloud for you 5G network sizing for V2E networks. Due to limited time, we are assisted by Russell from Amazon Foley, an AI spokesman. Hi, Russell.
Hi there. My name is Russell. I've been called to help Mr. Kuo in his presentation. As I read even pages, he will read odd ones. Okay, let's start.
Abstract. Market score for 5G network size. It tends as a collection of logical network function and parameter configs tailored to support the specific requirements. In this article, we present our vision of the design of 5G network size customized for V2E. The sizing solution involves the partition of core and the reload accessible resources to configure the end-to-end functionality to support more use cases.
Introduction to 5G systems. 5G is a highly flexible and programmable end-to-end communications, network and computing infrastructure, with upgraded throughput, latency, reliability, capacity, and mobility, whilst meeting requirements from multiple services. Several organizations, including 3GPP, agree on the convergence of mobile broadband, so that physical structure can be accessed using network slices. E2 has divided them into three major use cases: enhanced mobile broadband EMBB, massive machine-type communications MMTC, and ultra-reliable and low-latency communications ERLC.
Network size is referred to as a collection of core network CN and radio access network RAN functions whose setting are configured to meet the diverse use cases requirements in terms of functionalities and delivery performance. Automobile vertical markets drive the 5G so that V2X and its enhancement eV2X have been included by 3GPP in long-term version LED release 14. Referred by number 5 and 6, and among the 5E use cases, referred by number 2 and 7. 5E V2X network is drawing public interest right now.
V2X use cases we know are self-driving cars, HD video streaming and real-time navigation systems. Despite unclear potential benefits and business opportunities, network slicing for the 5G era is rapidly shaping up as a key technological enabler of the future automotive market. What will we do in the experiment? We will discuss the 5G V2X technological and architectural options, concerns, and open issues. Thus, this is the first time that they are analyzed as crucial components of the end-to-end 5G slicing for V2X services.
V2X services in 3GPP. So far, IEEE 802.11 OCB mode has been considered the de facto standard access technology for vertical networking. Reference number 4 will take a while to equip most vehicles with this protocol. Meanwhile, 3GPP is defining the full set of V2X technical enablers in releases 14 and 15. There are two sidelink radio sources, scheduled mode under the control of the scheduled infrastructure, i.e. DA0B, and the autonomous modes, with UE autonomously selecting the sidelink resources from the free configurable pool 1, may be required for out-of-coverage UE operations. Note that the UE in coverage will have the scheduled mode.
3GPP identifies four types of V2X communication modes. V2V and V2P modes cover direct communication among VUEs and between them, and the VIU V2I refers to communications between vehicles and the RSU implemented either in an E-node BOR as a standalone stationary UE. A VUE and the RSU exchange data over the LTE UU interface. The RSU can transmit toward multiple VUEs in each area through the IMBMs. V2N puts vehicular UEs in communication with a server supporting V2N applications, referred to as a V2X application server. As which provides a centralized control.
Okay, for this table, V2X use cases and related KPI. Russell will explain why each V2X category have a certain values of latency, data rates, and reliability.
For safety and traffic efficiency in V2V/V2P, a vehicle carry position and kinematics parameters to war other vehicles and VIUs, like forward collision, cooperative adaptive cruise control, and VIU safety. For teleoperated driving in human-unfriendly environments, drones on wheels may command to self-drive by an off-board human-controlling camera, status, and sensor data. Tactile internet exhibits tight requirements for the network to ensure fast vehicle control and feedback. ADVs have stricter safety measures than those of V2V because not only they drive fast and close to each other, but also full road network coverage. V2V networks enhance this form of service. Remote diagnostics and management. A V2X app server via V2N can track a vehicle's status for diagnosis, whose quality doesn't matter. For the infotainment, web browsing and media streaming for passengers are considered a must-have for passengers.
5G network slicing and overview. Why two sides of the network? Multiple services are both porting over the same architecture elastically. sizing the CN segment, updated control plane functionalities, warping data management, section management, authentication, user plane UPL functionalities, etc. Sizing the RAM is a late matter and challenging process due to the challenges of various resources. Also, encompass various 0 and 0 day or RAD parameters like time, frequency resources, frame size, and the HARC options. Network sizing logically isolates network function events and resources on a single infrastructure, a size span of 5G network domains across CN and RAD segments. Despite complication in size design in favor, end-to-end approach that ensures high flexibility, allowing some of the CS function to be placed in the RAN to meet the strict latency and scalability constraints.
The most promising slicing is to decouple the CP and the UP functionalities and leveraging open API and programmability of network functions, which allows placing UP near users and CP in the CO. Virtual NFS is dynamically instantiable, relocable and scalable as VM or containers. In early 3GPP attempts, network slicing was conceived to deploy DACORs running on the NF hosting hardware. Thanks to NFV, CP and UP NFS are deployable as virtual NFS and platform independent, hosted in the remote or the edge cloud. An SDN controller can configure VNF and PNF chains in each slice and flexibly interconnect UP/CP functionalities.
5G slicing for the V2X devices. Figure 1 illustrates some representative functionalities or interfaces in the V2X ecosystem deploys as VNFs in the remote or edge cloud and interconnected through the SDN, interfaces, the RAN, and the CN domains. Okay, the picture is good, right? In the V2X ecosystem, network slicing can effectively cope with various use cases and demand provided over the 5G infrastructure by multiple tenants. With 5 ISP, new players will enter the scene. The unique features of V2X service do not allow easy straightforward mapping or mapping into a single V2X size. Therefore, based on the main KPIs and functional requirements, we propose the forceful reset of sizes as illustrated in the figure to the next page.
Safety used by the Road Authority. The slice for autonomous driving and other safety critical services relies on ultra low latency V2V as the prevalent RAD connection mode and on additional RAN/CN functions, such as for network controlled resource allocation over the PC5 interface, in the eNode, and mobility, authentication, authorization, and subscription management, i.e., in the MME and HSS. Moreover, low latency and reliable video/data exchange needs to be supported with the V2X as deployed at the network edge that helps the augmented vision.
The teledriving side should ensure ultra low latency and highly reliable end-to-end connectivity between the controlled vehicle and the remote operator. Unlike the autonomous driving side, such service will be extremely limited and occasionally activated, resulting in a light over the CN. The enforcement size, however, is expected to use multiple RAD for higher throughput and to host content easily to bring more crowd across the user at the eNode B. Multiple LV instances may be required.
The vehicle remote diagnostics and management slice has to be configured to support the exchange of small amounts of low frequency data between many vehicles and remote servers outside the CN. To this purpose, UP functionalities should handle multiple interactions, for example, through multiple SPGW instances, and CP functionalities, for example, the MME, should be instantiated accordingly. On the next page, Table 2 summarizes the main configuration for the identified V2X slices, whose design is driven by the following main issues.
Okay, let's take a look at this table. The configuration for the main identifies V2X slices. For the application server required, replacement. Okay, for the environment, can be either placed in the edge cloud or remote cloud. For the analyzer, it has to be placed in the remote cloud, I mean the server. Okay, for the server of the autonomous domain is not needed, since the V2V over the PC5 is a communication mode, okay? As the driver parameters is required for teledriving. For the main configuration, primitive, broadcast or uniclass. Everything is uniclass. For the autonomous domain is broadcast. Every side sales, SDR support, type, level, assist, hard support. For the autonomous driving, not needed. Local among you is for V2V comms. For the RAN settings, everyone has 4G or 5G NR. For the TTINs, everyone else but the default resentment is short. And you may take a snapshot for additional details.
For the network slicing design issues and criteria, the design of an end-to-end V2X slice should allow the dynamic composition of different slice instances. The 3GPP multidimensional slice descriptor, 8, should be enriched with other parameters that better identify the slice configs. Vehicular devices would likely be conceived as multi-slice devices that can attach to multiple slices simultaneously. Multi-tenancy is a typical feature of the V2X scenario. Different services mapped onto different slices may be offered by different providers. And finally, slice customization should also be related to the UE type.
Slicing the RAID for V2X. Slicing the RAID functionality means span from the selection of RAID and RAN architecture. RAID selection, 5GB will deploy a smash up of existing and over 3GPP and of 3GPP. Access technologies. In the V2X context, cellular technologies provide cellular ubiquitous coverage, whereas F.2.1 OCP may be desirable to offload 3GPP networks. A V2X size configuration enters the selection of the RAID, able to satisfy the KPIs, adaptability to changing network condition. In particular, the use of multiple RAIDs may be configured to enlarge the 4-10-man size or fortify the teledriving sizes. The RAN architecture, V2X size could benefit from the on-demand deployment and offline function. The shift to the cloud RAN CRAN technology with a pre-VO and baseband function functionality with a RAID 1 migrate to the cloud and form in a baseband unit pool, or BBU. By leveraging virtualization, cellular resources at the pool can be allocated to NOP according to the network broad. This is to adaptability to the non-real-form traffic scenarios. Moreover, a centralized processing of the pool BBU functionalities reduce the time and the signaling for handovers.
Communication mode and primitive selection. The V2X slice configuration requires the mapping of the traffic flow onto a communication mode and a primitive. Release 14 specifies broadcast primitives to match V2V/V2P safety services. Reliable unicast would also play a crucial role in safety-aware applications like platooning. Multicast could be used by RSUS/NodeBs to reach wide area UAs. For the RRA, although each slice shares a RACHT, it plays a key role of allocating resources inter-slice and intra-slice. Slicing of radio resources can occur in the time/frequency domains, such as LTE resource blocks. Additionally, slicing can be enforced by setting a packet forwarding rules as captured by the QCI of the bearer. Besides the QCIs defined in 5, to meet the V2X latency and reliability requirements over the LTE-UU interface, further QCIs should be conceived for V2X slices with stricter requirements. Among the 3GPP scheduling schemes, dynamic scheduling well matches the requirements of the infotainment slice. Meanwhile, semi-persistent scheduling is chosen for auto-drive and remote diagnostic slices.
Numerology. V2X support will be achieved in 5G for 3.9 frequency numerology. For instance, long TTI, it is 1 milliseconds. If you use real throughput demanding applications like Vigera before the main size, while short TDIs like 0.15 milliseconds is 2.5 feedback, like teleoperating driving size.
The MME plays a key role in the CN by managing mobility, session, authentication, and authorization. The high vehicle speed in all V2X slices may either overload the MM funk of the MME or inefficiently use them at peak hours. To avoid them, the slicing design shall enable multiple MME instances to be flexibly deployed as VNFs and interconnected to meet the needs of the V2X slices.
By decoding in these funks, MME function can be co-located within the ENOP to the low latency as shown in figure 3 for the auto-driving size. Such a composition ensures the design of new lightweight interfaces to let the split MME funks interact with each other. In figure 3, the MME is interconnected to the AU module and the SSS to match its subscription authorization procedures of device on both self-driving cars. DSU and SSS can be deployed as VNFs common to auto V2X size.
For the EMBMS, the auto-drive slice may require the on-the-fly activation of multicast flows to allow the dissemination of road safety accident-related info. Nodes supporting EMBMS funks are typically located in the CN. The backhaul delay between the BMSC and the E-node may be non-negligible. Thanks to CP-up decoupling, the user plane of EMBMS CN functions can be moved closer to the E-node to ensure safety data to be promptly broadcasted by leveraging NFV techniques.
The app servers typically is a device outside the LTV network. In perfect usage, one ordered by various service providers. Thanks to the EMC enabling technology, V2X AS instances can run close to users to get short latency. The V2X AS supporting the self-driving cars is deployable at the network edge. The placement of V2X AS in remote cloud facilities is doable for delay tolerant, like remote diagnosis services. Infotainment servers may also benefit from NFV and MBC solutions. As the vehicle move, the infotainment slice can be more effective if coupled with V2X strategies. The data contents move from the edge node to the edge nodes, e.g. e-node BS, to keep the service continuous.
Slicing the user device for V2X, slicing may also encompass the configuration of some settings or functions in the vehicular device. For instance, vehicular and V.R.U.ZUAs exhibit different capabilities, requiring different configs for the same safety involving slice. Although the network is expected to retain control over the V2V or V2P side link comms, some control functionalities could benefit from the RAN or CN and the UE being split, such as retransmissions, handled by VU in the auto-drive mode over PC5 links. Adaptation of link parameters, autonomously performed by the UE. When out of coverage, the UE should can autonomously select the set of slice configs to match the services of interest. Lastly, it may be convenient to extend the up to the extreme edge of the network. For instance, a vehicular UE can locally host a lightweight V2X's instance to serve other UEs in proximity. And a slice should be able to support UEs acting as a storage unit to disseminate local infotainment contents, and as a cloud processing unit.
Operational and business open issue for feedback sizing, sizing management organization required for main capabilities, size description, face capture the requirement of a given SLA, size station and purposes, the identification of CPU V architecture interfaces, set VNF or BNF EDCN and the interconnection and parameter setting in the RAM device. Size lifecycle management, entail config, adaptation, monitoring to fulfill isolation constraint and accurate SLA. A person manager is in charge of the two latter functionalities. It is the slicing orchestrator, which in turn communicates with SCNFV or MANO platform and enables the blocking of NFV resources between multiple sites and resources in Figure 3. When requesting a given service, a feedback device should be able to either select the required size or receive from the network the indication of what the activated size. Due to high dynamicity of the different requirements, the complex nature of feedback services and the expected edge-dominated network infrastructures, such operation will get much more complicated than in other 5G contexts.
Network slicing in 5G is expected to overturn traditional business models. Operators may provide in an agile manner a tailored network slice for their customers from different vertical markets as a service. 9. On the other hand, the business model behind 5G-based V2X for MNOs is still under debate. 4. New partnerships will likely emerge between automotive players. To this aim, suitable open APIs must be designed. Cybersecurity should be guaranteed in 5G V2X with low overhead and latency. 4, 6. In addition, security threats could specifically emerge through network slicing usage in 5G V2X. Security procedures should be tailored to the needs of the different use cases.
For now, we are going to conclude this paper. This article elaborates on the role of network slicing for each use case to obtain the isolated region and to guarantee performance of 5G feedback services. Suggestions are provided to contribute to the design of dedicated feedback slices, meant to better address the unique peculiarities and not to create bottlenecks in existing reference sizes, while specifically supporting vertical applications. However, we do not disregard the possibility of properly customizing sites belonging to a set of basic reference sizes to manage them. For the example, S is a subtype of proper composition of different size instances. In this case as well, the provided guidelines still apply. And that's the end of the presentation. Thank you, Russell, for helping me save time.
You're welcome, Rick.